Hello and welcome to another Friday No Man's Sky video. Thank you to everyone who subscribed, liked, or commented on any of my videos. With the recent news with the possibility of a delay till July or August, I spent a lot of time rolling around the idea of putting out this video. But with almost every retailer website in the US still holding true to the June 21st release date, I decided a different topic could help bring some positivity back to the spotlight. With all that being said, if Sony or Hello Games does confirm the delay, after I post this, I will still be leaving this video up. With it being just over 2 weeks away from E3 2016, I would like to take a look at if we will see No Man's Sky at E3, and if we do, what we will see or be told. First off, will we see anything from No Man's Sky at E3? Yes. I'm 98% sure that Sony will have at least 10 minutes lined up for Sean Murray and No Man's Sky. No Man's Sky is a big IP for Sony, and with all the hype that has been built around No Man's Sky, I would find it rather odd if Sony didn't give up the stage time to promote the launch of a new IP launching the following week. As someone in marketing myself, I would assume Sony has told the team working on No Man's Sky that they need something at E3 to push No Man's Sky pre-orders through the roof. So what could they announce at E3 about No Man's Sky that would make players like you and I drop $60 on an indie game? Well, I believe there are three things the internet has been buzzing about and asking for clarification on for quite some time now. These are listed in order of least likely to be announced to most likely to be announced. Number 3. Virtual reality compatibility. The reason to announce it? Sony will be launching VR within the year, and this would be a great game to bundle with a VR headset. Reason not to announce it. Sony will have other VR titles it will be announcing that they will want to push, and it's not the most asked for feature. Number 2. Multiplayer. Reason to announce it at E3. It is the most asked about and talked about question associated with No Man's Sky. Reason not to announce it. Sean Murray has stated that this is not that game. He has also stated that a multiplayer function of sorts is being looked into as a post-year one feature. This was stated in an Edge magazine article, and I'll make sure to link it below. The most probable feature of No Man's Sky I can think of would be some sort of in-game player communication. Sean has hinted at this before in other interviews. Why would they announce this feature now, though? Well, I believe this would give players not only something to do, but it would serve as kind of a middle ground for players looking for an MMO. Sony and Hello Games are not looking to break new IP or indie title records. Sony is looking to sell more consoles, and in turn more games, and Hello Games is looking to provide something we can't exactly get from any other console game. So think of it this way, if it's gonna give away something big about the game, we won't see it at E3. If it's a prominent feature in any other game on the PS4, we will not see it at E3 either. As far as a launch trailer, I'm 80% sure we will see that as well, but what will a launch trailer show us that we have not already seen is the real question. Then there's the chance that we will see nothing at all and be told the release date has been pushed to November of 2020 and will be released alongside The Last Guardian. And the funny part is I wrote that the morning before the news broke about the delay. What do you think we will see from Sony and Sean Murray regarding No Man's Sky at E3 2016? Let's continue the discussion in the comments below, and until next week, game on.